My dad always in his genealogy said somebody in our family supposedly was hung as a witch. And I never could find the connection, and he could never tell me where the connection was. And I have since discovered that the rich line may have had, I think it's Martha Corey, who was somehow a rich before that, either married to a rich or rich, but we still can't find out where it is, except that it is in written language that I've run across. So he had that, but then I ran across a line that my grandmother on the Weber side goes right into that witch trial thing, and there were a lot of our relatives, the Toothakers, direct line that were involved. And many of those people who died were faithful, God-fearing people. And because they refused to lie and say, I am a witch, they were killed. Those who admitted that they were a witch and they did it to save themselves were not put to death. And so it was these good people who said, I'm not going to lie and say I'm a witch. I know. And they were very good people. There was a lot of other stuff going on at the time, political stuff, squabbles over land and other things that they think affected this hysteria that took place. But the people weren't what they were being accused of. And it's just weird to me, or whatever, to know that good people were killed because they refused to lie. And so there's that story. We have relatives that were killed by Indians. I've run across that, and I don't know. It's hard for the rich line to get across. I think I've got as close as anybody to a person being born in the time frame that was supposed to be born. But all it says is that the father, his name was Richard Rich, but his father's name, they just put Rich down there. So we don't know who. But it's in a different, totally different area than they expected. People are trying to connect us to Lord Chancellor Rich, and he was a terrible person. He was responsible for torturing people. And after doing all the history work that I've done, I don't care if I'm related to him. But this other group seems like it's more religious and more earthy. And the more I've become aware of the kings and the queens and all the craziness that goes on in that, I don't care if I don't know who would want to be a queen or a king, because there's always some intrigue, death-threatening, whatever involved. And they, a lot of times, the ones that were good, people didn't respect. And the ones that, it seemed like the ones that treated them with more authority and stuff, the people were afraid of, but they respected them. And it's like really twisted, you know. I had a great-grandfather, I guess it was, that was a game warden in Maine. That means they, like if somebody's, like, there are certain times of the year that you're allowed to, or certain areas of the forest where you're allowed to, shoot animals and stuff. And he enforced the rules. You know, you have to have a license. Even back then, there were certain rules. You can't, sometimes if there was posted land, you cannot shoot anybody's. If you have posted land, you're not supposed to be on it for any reason. And that means you have signs on the fences and stuff surrounding your land saying nobody's allowed on this property. So, I don't know, they do that kind of thing. Or if there was some kind of wild animal that got out of control, they might be the ones that have to make sure that it's taken care of so somebody doesn't get hurt.